You know, if there's anything I like about early 80s video games, it's the weird abstract nature that most of them have. It often feels like you can literally make a game out of anything, no matter how nonsensical it may be. And it'll work! You know, like a yellow dot that eats ghosts, or a chef making giant hamburgers while being chased by sausages. It's like anything goes in this time period. That brings us to our current game, Make Trax. Look at that logo. It's majestic. You can see all the effort put in. Far out. How far do you want me to go? If I go too far, I can't even play this game, man. I'm not fucking Plastic Man. I'm as far as I can go. Make Trax as you playing as a paintbrush out to paint an entire maze. This would be easy if it wasn't for the fact you're being chased by fish. Fish that leave their aquariums to go chase you. How these fish manage to leave their aquariums and chase you down, I've got no idea. Hell, I don't even know how they're chasing me in the first place. And what kind of harm could a flying fish do to an anthropomorphic paintbrush anyways? Too bad it wasn't the 70s, at least then I could blame drugs and Jimi Hendrix for this mess. Speaking of your paintbrush, it looks less like a paintbrush and more like a fireball of some sort.
Hadouken!
There are other enemies in the game too, but they really don't hurt you as much as they're just a thorn in your tuchus. They go around making tracks in your fresh paint job, making you repaint it. The enemies you encounter include such things as a bird, the invisible man, a car, a cat, another cat, and a mouse. I think. It is a mouse, right? You'll be able to kill these bastards and gain a nice slice of bonus point pie just by merely touching them. Funny that they would name the game Make Trax after this play mechanic. It's nowhere close to the main focus, and it's one of the most annoying parts of the game. They even made the feet part of the logo. What's up with that? While Make Trax is the name I'm most familiar with when it comes to this game, I won't lie, the Japanese name of Crush Roller actually makes a lot more sense. Why? Well, let me talk about one of the main mechanics of the game, the paint roller. There's two paint rollers in the level that you can push. They give you a bit of a speed boost and will temporarily kill any fish that gets in its way. Unfortunately, you can only use this in a small stretch of land. This kind of prevents you from going all over the board, and after a short period of time, it kind of becomes useless because the fish get wise to this play mechanic really fast. But until then, you can use the roller to crush the fish, thus the name Crush Roller. Also, yes, you heard me right. The fish do get wise to your roller. Unlike Pac-Man, where the ghosts get faster and smarter with each level, Make Trax has the fish get smarter every time you kill them. This makes your roller nearly useless after you've crushed the enemies 3 or 4 times. After that, they'll either stay away from the roller entirely, or they'll ambush you at the end of the roller's route, which gets frustratingly difficult really early in the game. This probably wouldn't be so bad if the fish had some sort of pattern like the Pac-Man ghost, but instead they just seem to go straight for you. Is that blood? Is that Chris's blood? So yeah, with them getting really smart and programmed to go straight for you, you'll find yourself getting cornered a lot, and often pretty unfairly. Also, I'd be lying if I even tried to say this game wasn't inspired by Pac-Man. It's even got those little off-screen tunnels that you can take to get to the opposite side of the maze. And while Make Trax has more of them than Pac-Man, they aren't anywhere near as useful in Make Trax. See, in Pac-Man, going into one of these tunnels slows down the ghost a bit, allowing you to speed ahead, and also makes for an excellent strategy. This is not in effect in Make Trax. Here, the fish's speed don't change at all, and if they're on your tail when you go into a tunnel, chances are you're going to get killed as soon as you get to the other side. This pretty much reduces the tunnels to nothing more than a shortcut to areas of the maze that you could probably get to just as easily without. Once you paint the entire maze, you go to the next maze, which is the absolute same maze, except now you color it a different color than the last level. Wow, going from neon green to pink? Can't get much more 80s than that. Now, with everything I've talked about so far, I haven't mentioned Make Trax's greatest sin, the sound. Oh my god, it feels like someone is attacking my ear with their dick! Oh, I guess I should be impressed that a game from 1981 even has background music. That's if you want to call this music. By the way, if you go deaf from watching this review, please don't sue me. Oh my god, I think my ears are bleeding. Yep, they're bleeding. Oh, let's just stop this. Oh my god, I don't remember the last time I've ever had such an attack on my auditory senses. Let me find my eardrums so I can put them back into my head. So, overall, if you can get past the obvious audio atrocity, you'll find that Make Trax is actually a pretty mediocre Pac-Man clone that gets too hard too fast to have any long-lasting fun. I'd say it's worth a try, but I seriously doubt you're going to stay around for very long. That is, if the music doesn't kill you first. Oh, the music! It's in my head!